Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. In this tutorial, we'll take a look how to use our PayPal account to create secret ID and client ID so that we'd be able to use our PayPal account in our app, and with that you'd be able to receive money in your PayPal account, and users, they would be able to pay money to your PayPal account for buying products. Well, first take a look. This is our app where we can buy things. Just let me go ahead and go for checkout. Now, as you can see, we are checking out, and I'll click on a button over here, and it's loading the PayPal payment page. And as you can see, we can see the progress over here. Well, you see the page is still loading, and I think it would be done very soon. Now, as you can see, it's showing me a page where it says that I have this amount of money and whether I want to continue or not. But of course, this information is coming from test account or Sandbox account. So you can go ahead and click it, and it will also pop up with you a new page. That should be a login page actually. All right, because I already logged in early, so the payment was successful. So we'll see that how to go ahead and create a test account for our app testing, okay? But anyway, for that one, first you need to come to this page, which is called paypal.com. And over here, you will have this login option. If you don't have an account, go ahead and create one. I have already one. Creating a PayPal account is pretty easy. Anyway, so after that, you will come over here and log in. So we'll log in. And for login, it will take you to your own dashboard. And over here, you can click all tools. So it will take you to this to a page where there are many tools, okay? Now over here, you will click on integrate PayPal, okay? Now click on this developer site. One thing though, to integrate your PayPal in an app, you should upgrade your personal account to business account. Otherwise, you won't be able to do that, because after all, you're going to receive money from your account, okay? Or pay money to someone else. So it's better you should have a business account. Anyway, after that, you'll click over here, REST APIs. Now here we do have options where it says that log into developer dashboard, okay? All right, so I already have an account, so I don't need to do this, okay? So what I will do in this case, I'll come over here in Sandbox, okay, where it says overview. So I'll click on this one. Do remember that before you go ahead, you have to create a developer account, and you can do it from here, okay? I already have it, and it's just simple steps. Go ahead and fill in some information, that's all. And then you will come over here, accounts, okay? And let's see, okay, we should click on overview actually. Now here, we'd go over here. Now, this is only opened if you created your developer account after creating your PayPal account and after upgrading it to a business account, and then you come over here and say this. Now over here, we have to create a Sandbox account. Sandbox account means that you are going to test your account in app, which means that in your app, you are going to use PayPal. Now, first we need to do test because we are going to deal with money. Anyway, so once you click on this one, it will take a page like this, and here it will create an app, okay? So create an account. Now over here, first we'll create a business account. With this account, we'll have secret ID and client ID, which we'll use in our app for taking money, okay? Now here, we'll choose my location. You can choose your location. So first we created a business account. Well, I already have a few I created early. Now this is the one I created, 013 or 1013. And once that is done, now we need to go ahead and create an app. Now, well, app is over here actually, app name. And then once we need to do that because we want to bind our business account with our app, okay? So we'll click over here. It will take us to a new page. Now here, app and credentials. Well, because we are going to do it in sandbox mode, so we need to choose this one. This is the live mode, which means that if your app is already in the market, or if you're going to publish your app, then you use this one. Otherwise, you use this one, okay? Now, I already created a few, and I'll create a new one. I'll create here, create app. And once again, here it asks you to give it an app name, so I'll call it e-commerce app. That's all. And then this is our business account 1013, which one we just created. We'll choose this one, and then it will help us to create an app. Okay, well, here creating app means getting your client ID and a secret ID. Let's see what's going on. So I'm in China, sometimes it doesn't work. Yes, now it's okay. Now here, this is your client ID, and over here is your secret ID, okay? So you need to click on the show button and it'll show you the ID, okay? Now in general, this, okay, it may take a bit of time in my case. Okay, now we see this one, okay? So in general, this kind of information, client ID and secret ID, you'd put in your backend, okay? And backend, using a RESTful API request, your app would read this information from your backend or from the database. Okay, so you can save them in database or somewhere else in your backend, it doesn't really matter. So you don't have to remember them, they're always there. So just if you, when you go ahead and use them, just come over here, choose your app, and then go ahead and copy them and put in your backend. Well, now with this is the merchant or business account and app that we created, okay? Now this would be used in your backend. Now from the front end, you also have to test it. Like this is a business account where you want to receive or accept payments. Now we also have to simulate a user behavior, which means we also have to have an user account. And for this one, we'll come over here once again, okay? Now here you have to create another account, okay? Now this time it would be a personal account, and I'll choose China for now, okay? So now here you'd see it created a personal account. Now once you test your app, this is the personal account ID that you are going to use. So as you see, your email ID and a password. Of course, you can change the password over here. And if you want to change the email address, you need to click over here and add it and change your email address. So with this too, you'd be ready to use your PayPal information over here, which is user account and business account information, to accept payment, and as well as to simulate making payment, okay? Now here I do already have this app over here. Now let me show you. So this app actually works. Like I can go ahead and place an order, okay? Now I'll click over here and I'll click checkout. Now it will take me to a payment account where I do have this PayPal button. Now this one, well, it may take a bit of time to load because I'm in China. So, well, as you see, it took me to this page where it wants me to type in my personal account and password. Now that's what I'm going to do. And for this one, actually, let's see. My personal account is this one, the one I created early, and this is the password. So I'll go ahead and type in. So that should be Q8XW9, and I can view the password. Yes, right. So I'll click on this one, and it'll take me to the payment page. And once again, it may take a bit of time, but what's happening, I can view it on my app over here. Let me see. Yes, so the loading has been done. So I can click on this. Okay, it'll take me to a page where it says that it's being processed. Okay. All right. So it's being processed right now, but it's all in Chinese though, because my computer is in Chinese. Anyway, so now the payment has been done. Yes. So that's how pretty much you go ahead and create your sign in PayPal account and use that account to generate a secret ID, client ID, and after that you'll have two kinds of ID. One is business account ID and personal account ID. Business account ID will connect with your backend, and personal account ID you'll log in when you pay. All right, but how to exactly integrate this information with your backend and frontend? If you want to know, check out the link below I have, so that you don't miss any information. Okay, thank you so much.